and it was a new term for me, Intermountain West. And I sort of remembered her bringing the term up. She sort of remembered us bringing the term up first. So here's what it turned out to be. Well, to be blunt, we sat ourselves down and said, quote, let's take the fucker on. So we did. Conversations back and forth, investigations back and forth, differences in persona, commonnesses in ethical concerns, that kind of stuff goes on. Well, that's the basis for forming a collaboration. What shows up here in this first draft, let me say, is both similarity and difference. Where it's discovered that 750,000 square mile terrain has been violated in so many ways that parts must be abandoned. Thereafter it's discovered, thank you, Warren, that with the boundaries removed, 1,330,000 square miles becomes a new frame for the Intermountain West, and a new country wants to happen. So, who'd have thunk it? Certainly not in the beginning. So, also shows up a kind of difference in the way we map, but not a difference in what we mean when we map. For instance, there's the Intermountain West, our way of seeing, with the Great Basin in it. And you can see it takes up almost a third of the country. No, maybe a fifth. That's a lot of country. Well, I'm not going to stay too long on this. So the first thing we do is we map all the cities. Mapping all the cities is really neat because it makes a kind of a drawing. And we decide to stick to the states, to the United States boundary, for at least this fragment of work. And it sort of shows up that the Intermountain West has fewer people than most places. It's a good idea that it has fewer people because it's the most violated place in the country. We think, we'll get to it later, that things like this took it up. Look at it. It's the most atom bombed place in the country. The idea that we would be afraid of others and then bomb ourselves in response is beyond belief. Therefore, our proposal, seen simply, is time to abandon this place. It's time to abandon this place.
We who aspire toward a nation that protects living things find it difficult to escape the irresponsible actions that have rendered vast territories of our continent unusable. The cost of living in the most violent empire in history is the cost we now assume in addressing the rebalance of catabolic descent. We hereby proclaim an independent nation, a nation formed to support the human species, the pollinators, the remaining wild equine, the fish and soaring birds. We name our new country Rose. Rose is a coalition of watersheds. It includes the Colorado River watershed, the Columbia River watershed, the Great Basin, the Gulf of Mexico seaboard, the Pacific Ocean seaboard, and the Rio Grande. Here's our analytical map of our inheritance, the as-built of the North American continent, with the major water bodies, and the major tributaries that fall from there. Here's a contour map of the North American continent, and you can see the as-built of the mountain ranges as dark black lines and the deserts in white. The sea, of course, is also white at the lowest contours. You can see the Great Basin and the Sierra, You can see the Central Valley of California. And what's tinted pink is the beginnings of the footprint of the Nation of Rose. The coalition of watersheds, as Newton and Helen have already explained, has the least presence of human impact and the most presence of the violence exacted in the North American continent. The orange dots here are uranium mines that are mostly concentrated around the Colorado River, which was the river that John Wellesley Powell is so well known for exploring. And John Wellesley Powell is also the explorer who the United States commissioned many explorations of, across what was known as the arid lands, and he came back with a very sensible way of looking at habitation of the arid lands, which was that we should live within the concept of the drainage basin, that the Intermountain West was largely geographically about ridges and basins, and all of those basins contain the remainder of the two great ancient lakes, Bonneville and Lahontan. So while the land is arid, the basins are actually full of water, and any settlement could survive if we learned basin by basin how to govern ourselves. So his proposition in the 1870s and the 1880s, when the United States was looking to acquire the arid lands, was that we think not about land acquisition, but we think instead about, think of water basin government. So the coalition of Rose, the country that we propose forming so that we can allow entropy rebalance to occur, is in many ways part of this re-looking at the Powell map. I used a legal format called a convention. The UN allows conventions to be read, which allow for the redefinition of country or continent. Gandhi, for example, wrote a convention that he delivered at the UN on human rights. This, what I'll read with this animation of the hydraulics of Los Angeles and its relationship to the Intermountain West, is a convention on the elimination of all forms of aggression on the watersheds of Rhodes. We define ourselves as a nation for the purpose of a common language. Natio, or the place that we're born, is a term which unites us rather than separates us in the way prior national boundaries have often done so. We do so with the single purpose of healing and supporting the watersheds of our common asset, the peaks and valleys of the Intermountain West, and forming this coalition to speak for all those living beings who cannot speak for themselves, the vanishing wild animal kingdom that still survives in Rose Cow, or the coalition of watersheds. Convinced that the establishment of Rose will protect the well-being of the four adjacent watersheds, the Columbia, the Colorado, the Rio Grande, and the Great Basin, and taking into account that Rose's territories are within the footprint of the Intermountain West, like rivers, our nation's boundary aspires toward the shoreline. Part two, bearing in mind that whenever possible, we, the citizens of Rose, will not tolerate any aggression towards our watersheds, including, but not limited to, exploitive mining operations, energy grids that compromise life forms, toxic residue burials, desecration of sacred spaces, outmoded short-term gains to support mega-developments in outside watersheds. Part three, emphasizing that parts of the Great Basin, Columbia, and Colorado watersheds are highly damaged by uranium mines, nuclear test sites, and plutonium production. In addition, the Columbia River and Colorado River and Rio Grande are polluted by agricultural runoff, human waste, and industrial pollutants such as arsenic, dioxin, and PCBs. The Colorado River, Columbia River, and Rio Grande are heavily dammed to provide power for major cities, and water for agriculture drastically changes the river's ecosystems and jeopardizes the survival of native and anadromous fish populations. Part 4. Aware that the snowpack of the Sierra Nevadas, the Rocky Mountains, and the Cascade Range has been fully allocated for human use, leaving very little water for ecosystem functions, the current economic growth model is incongruent with the physical reality of water availability in the watersheds of the Rose. Bearing in mind that global warming is threatening the coastlines on both sides of the continent and will likely have a destabilizing effect on climate throughout the world, the country of Rose is formed to face the challenges of adaptation to new climatic conditions and the goal of preserving life for all living beings. Affirming that Rose accepts responsibility for the glacial time rebound of our common watershed, together we organize ourselves around tending to this long-term patient waiting rather than exploiting her natural assets for short-term gains.